Hi there on Typical Books. Today we're doing the Mid-Year Freakout tag. And that is like a mid-year catch-up. I don't typically do this catch-up because the questions are geared toward maybe YA and fantasy readers, I think, and you'll notice when I skip a few of them. I've done this tag before and skipped basically the questions that don't really fit for my sort of reading or horror, but hey, it is a nice time to do a mid-year freakout. I don't do one every year, but I figured because there's so many cool books coming up and I've read a few really great books I want to highlight again, I thought this tag would be really welcome right now. Question number one is the best book you've read so far in 2024, and that is The Haunting of Elkwood by Gwendolyn Keist. And you've heard me say how much I love this. It is my top book, I think, this year, and I think it will continue to be my top book this year. I have a lot of really great reading to do, but I think this, you know, was just so cool and it's really stuck with me. So yeah, this is my top book of the year. Question number two is best sequel you've read in 2024, and I haven't read it yet. I don't read a lot of sequels. And horror, I read a lot of standalone, and there are more standalone books in the horror genre, it seems. So for a series, I am reading and enjoying and looking forward to Clown in a Cornfield 3, Church of Frendo. So I will say that's my top sequel of the year, even though I haven't read it yet. I'm just gonna guess. I know I'm gonna have a lot of fun with it. I think it's even gonna be better than part two, but yeah, very excited to read that. I will say it's the best sequel because I don't read any series. I can't even think of a series in horror that I'm reading otherwise. Number three is new release that you have not read yet that you want to. And those in the know that I talk about new releases a lot. I curate the new release list for the Horror Writers Association at horror.org. I keep a big list at typicalbooks.com of new releases coming out. I do videos here about new releases. There's a poll up on Patreon right now with 4 new releases that I can't choose between. So yeah, new releases. Bury Your Gaze by Chuck Tingle maybe, or of course The Deading by Nicholas Bellardis, or what else is on that list? Ghost Camera by Darcy Coates and Heads Will Roll by Josh Winning, which is so far winning that poll. But yeah, so Bury Your Gaze by Chuck Tingle. If I had to pick one, because I don't think that'll win, but maybe I will want to read it. I don't know. Number four is most anticipated release for the second half of the year, and that is The Queen by Nick Cutter. And that comes out near the end of the year. I think it's coming out for like Halloween. And if I'm lucky, I'll get to see him at DreadCon in Waterloo, Ontario in September. So maybe I'll hear more about it. And if I get to get a sneak read or a reading from it, then I'll let everyone know. But yeah, I'm really looking forward to The Queen. A girl goes missing and her best friend finds her phone. And it's been a month. There's text messages from her happening on it. So it turns into a sort of a race against time. I think it all happens in one day. So it sounds like it's going to be a real thriller of a horror story. It looks like a B-grade kind of throwback 80s horror story, but in nowadays. So I don't know. Sounds like a really cool entry from Nick Cutter. Biggest disappointment is question number 5. And I don't usually like to answer this sort of question, but Withered was a bit of a disappointment. I thought it would not be as YA as it was. But yeah, I mean, I don't like answering this question usually, but I did already talk about how it wasn't really for me. Question 6, biggest surprise, The Haunting of Elkwood. Again, hello. It is not that I didn't think it would be good. I knew it would be good, but I didn't know it would be this good, and I didn't know it would stick with me so much, and I didn't anticipate wanting to read it again immediately, which is weird. I've never really been in that position, maybe with some fun Richard Layman books that I tore through, and I read this quickly. It is a little book, but man, I want to read it again. I want to see a movie. Question 7 is favorite new author, new to you or new author, new debut author. And I usually do read a lot of debut authors each year, but this is like revisiting Ronald Malfi. I've read maybe 4 Ronald Malfi books in my time, and I really, really, really like his writing. And I'm just looking forward to more. There's more this year coming too. So yeah, Small Town Horror was great. And it made me think of how much I enjoyed Snow when I read it. And I thought, oh man, I gotta read more Ronald Malfi. And I still think that. So I really have to read more Ronald Malfi. And then we get into questions I'm not really gonna answer. 8, newest fictional crush. Not applicable. Number 9, newest favorite character or whatever. Not That doesn't apply to me. Number 10, a book that made you cry. A book that made you smile is number 11. Books, questions that really are geared to the fantasy and YA genres, I think. Those are just weird questions. I have no real answers for those because I don't do those things. You know, smile and cry. Question 12, the most beautiful book you got this year, whether you bought it or it was a gift. And it was a gift, maybe not even really this year, but it was when I turned this age that I am now. It was a gift from my husband. And it's not like a Suntup or Subterranean. It's not a super special edition that costs a lot of money, but it's really cute. Grimm's Fairy Tales. It's just a neat little fabric bound with black and sort of a shimmery pearl white embossing on the cover. A neat little case. I think that that's a very cute little case. It looks really cute, almost like girly on my shelves, but still fits with the horror kind of feel. It's really nicely illustrated throughout the whole book, so I think that it's just a really good addition. I love Grimm's Fairy Tales, so this is a perfect reading copy. I've got a few different copies, but this one isn't too special or expensive or like precious that I can't read it all of the time, and it feels good and storybook like to read, and it looks really cute on the shelf. Question 13 is lucky 13. What books do you need to read by the end of the year? The Keeper of the Key by Nicole Wilson. I have an ARC. It's coming out in November. Very excited. And that is a book that I really can't wait to talk about. Even though I haven't read it yet, I can't wait to talk about it already. When I interviewed her, I got excited about books to come. And I always will be a really big fan of Nicole Wilson here. And I also have some books off my shelf I need to read. The first one is an ARC. It's coming out soon. The release date was pushed back. Midwestern Gothic by Scott Thomas. If you like Kill Creek, you will really enjoy this. I have had a great time. I have one story left to go reading this. And then eventually a review will come out too. And last but not least, a reread. This Symbiotic Fascination by Charlie Jacob. This was a gift from my husband. It is mint. It is a gorgeous copy of this. And I read it a long time ago when I first discovered Kathy Koja. I read this classic of extreme and dark fiction, but I was bored by it. And I think that I had just read too much. It was a hot summer. I didn't have the attention span to devote, I think. So we're going to give it another shot. I'm excited though, because everyone I know who's ideas I trust when it comes to dark fiction loves this book, so we'll give it another try. So that is it for the July 2024 mid-year freakout tag. Are you freaking out? Did I freak you out? Are there any of these books that are already on your list as well, or have I introduced you to some new things you want to pick up? Let me know in the comments below, and have an ooky spooky day.